Get a hold of this and you lower it.
Yep.
Keep bringing her down and forward.
There we go. We're going to have to give it the old.
However, getting it from under there is still not going to be easy.
The wires are out of the way here.
Well, if we go, if we pull it sideways, oh no, because that's still up there. We're going to have to push it back and get those two tongues forward, right?
Yeah, if we can, I can probably push it back.
There's a bar here too. Right?
Probably just slide right out the front now.
Yep. Yeah, because those are, you can probably just pull it out the side too.
So we're gonna have to pull that outside, you think?
Nope, wherever you want it, right?
There's no good,
because if you put it there, it's not giving, that's giving your way. You probably want it here if you're repairing there, right?
Yeah, let's pull it to the side.
Oh yeah.
Call you tank. Should have had you doing this before your big competition. Oh yeah. Even if it's just in the front, that's good there.
Oh, it's fine.
Just now I can get into this zone.
It was just a center pin that was holding me back.
Speedo cable there.
There we go. Success.
All right, we're gonna take a look around here and see how things are underneath. You can kind of see where it's blacked a little bit where I sprayed. So it's a little improved over there as compared to where I didn't spray. And you can see it's a little bit darker, and that's with the rust converter stuff just in a spray can. I also have it in a brush on formula, but tonight what I'm going to do is give a little bit of a wire brush to this area And then I'm going to brush on phosphoric acid to try and do a rust conversion. And we'll see how that turns out in a day or so. And I'll show you guys what it looks like. Cheers. Okay, here we go. Just gonna brush this on a bit. I'll probably just do a little bit tonight. And see how this goes. And then check it tomorrow, and if it's working good, then I'll do the rest. Alright, I think that's not a bad area for testing the sulfuric acid. I've seen on other guys' channels and stuff where they've used it. And let it set overnight, dries the next day, and works. Looks amazing. I just used some of the rust conversion on metal, the spray on and brush on stuff when I did Luna, and it seemed to work pretty good. But I did have to take a lot more care, I suppose. I don't know if that's the right word. Prep work. Just to make sure that the metal surface was cleaned a bit more when I was doing it on Luna. This stuff, a little bit of a wire brush, and apply it, seems to be all that's needed. But I'm curious to see if this will be enough, or if it's going to take pretty aggressive sanding or wire wheel on a grinder or something to clean it. But I'm gonna do some tests on it. I've got the time while we're waiting for other parts, so let's see what it looks like over the next couple of days. And if it works, like some say, then we'll all learn it together. Here's a little look. Been a couple hours to get an idea of what it looks like up there. And I did a little bit more treatment up in the front here. And we'll see how that goes the next day. But it seems to be darkening up pretty good there in the back. That's the side that I haven't done yet. That's the side that we did do. Alright. It's been about 14 hours or so since I did some of the treatment here yesterday. And I did that side. And then you can look up and you can clearly see where I did a treatment and I haven't treated yet. And then as this sets and dries, it gets blacker and blacker and dries nice and clean, and it's looking pretty good. You can see at the back, I painted over on this side over here and up here, and this side we haven't touched. So I'm going to do this side today and up in here and give it a nice coat. Of course, that's my shadow going over top of everything, so it's hard to see, but that's kind of what it's looking like. So I'm going to get up in there and clean all that up and make sure that we get everything squared away. You can see the nastiness there. So that outrigger and the cross member above it, that's all going to get cut out. But right now I just want to get everything treated up in here and before I put the beam back in so that everything is nice and clean. The surface of this I will just put on a spray on like a dripless oil treatment. Maybe even... depending on how it finishes, maybe I'll cover it with like a PUR 15 or something like that to seal everything back up. But any metal that's good, we'll treat. Tapping it, finding any areas that are compromised, and we'll just work our way through it to get her done and fix her up. But it's all good. It is progressing. Cheers.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. Just want to give you a quick update. Did some work on Chazzer last night. Got a few things squared away, put the beam back in, got the ship linkage all put in place, got the e-brake all hooked back up, put the steering, was that a pitman arm? Can't remember, drag link, whatever it's called, connected back in and put everything back together, and realized that I hadn't hit the button to record some of that footage. It was going to be a time lapse. At any rate, this stuff is all back in. Today I'm going to put a new clutch cable hanging on a mirror there. I already had one here for Luna, kind of a spare, so I'm going to put that one in, ordered a couple more so that we have a spare for the vehicle for down the road in the future. Always good to carry a clutch cable, throttle cable, set of points if you're running points. Anyway, we'll have those things and going to get things squared away. So as we were doing some of the work in there, I have some still pictures. There was a repair on the frame area that we wanted to do. There was a compromised kind of area you can kind of see up in the front there. Put some more light on and we'll see what it is. So you can see some new metal and grinds and stuff. So we opened up a section in there and replaced any areas that were thin. The arch at the beam is nice. It's good and solid. The beam's in place, of course, with one bolt missing there, if anybody can see that. But I will be going to get some new lock washers and hardware for that, and I'll put all new hardware in there in the coming days. But right now everything's in place so I can do the clutch cable, put it back on its wheels, and then fire it up, roll it outside. I don't have brakes because there's one brake line that's broken, so I want to be able to roll it out. I'll use the e-brake. And I want to be able to get to my parts stash, which are on the shelf up above the bus up there. So I'm going to pull it outside here today and get the brake parts down that I have up there. And then we can replace the brake line, fill the system back up. I got to connect the rubber hoses at the front wheels yet as well. Bleed the system, get everything functioning there. And then should be good to go on the next step. And I'm likely going to keep working on the nose here and take another inch off of the nose so that I can get access to the panel that's behind the nose at that area that kind of goes on the inside, and the floor welds to it on the front inside edge of it, and that overlaps with this part at the nose here. But I need just a little bit more room to be able to get to that, clean up the surfaces, get this piece fitted in place. Got some more cleaning up to do. Got a little repair to do to the A-post in here. But the A-post solid, the thick metal beam post that comes down is good. There is a thin metal part that goes in front of it, and you can see holes in it right over here. That part I'm going to trim out. I'm going to make a new piece to put in there, weld all that up, make a new piece that goes along the bottom here. You can see I'm going to snip that away and use it as a template to make a new one to join the bottom of the dog leg A-post, and this inner front valance will all get joined together there, as well as they do in the back of the A-post. Right here, there's still some crusty stuff, but that's going to get all cleaned up, and there's a new plate that'll go across the back of this post and over here and weld to the backside of the new valance. So for today, I'll just put a time lapse in, or maybe just catch a couple little clips of putting the clutch cable in, and probably doing the brake lines a little bit later. So here we go.
Okay, here we're just getting the clutch cable put back in, applying some grease to the cable as I'm sliding it into the sleeve to go to the back, and then get the cable fitted in the back place, and she's all squared away. Okay, we've got the cable pushed all the way to the back. Now we'll get the clutch cable or clutch pedal mechanism all hooked back up and finish some adjusting. The clutch didn't adjust up exactly the way I want you. I'm going to have to get in there and adjust it again, but it was good enough to be able to at least move the vehicle. Here's not a real good angle to be able to see, but we've got both wheels on now. Took the jack stands out and set her back down on wheels so we can roll her out.